strength of a woman. Strength of a woman.
Hey guys, so welcome to my YouTube channel. I'm gonna say hearty thank you to all the persons who subscribed, and if you have not yet subscribed, you know what to do. Subscribe, click the notification bell, like, comment, and share. All right guys, so today for my first, I'll call it a personal video, I want to share with you what it is like to live with sickle cell disease, right? So I'm not going to share from a denotative, I'm not going to give you a denotative definition of what the illness is or share from that perspective. I'm going to share from a connotative perspective. So I'm just going to tell you what it is based on living with it, and share my experience and how it affects me daily. All right, so I'm going to try to talk about this as vibrant as possible. That way I don't get emotional and nobody watching this video gets emotional either. All right, so first and foremost, what is sickle cell disease? Well, in normal persons, the blood shapes like this. It has a circular shape. In sickle cell patients, it shapes like something like this, right? So it normally blocks the vessels in our body, the micro veins in our body, and causes crisis pain, right? So every person living with sickle cell may not experience the same symptoms, or they may not have the same what affects me might not affect somebody else. What affects somebody else might not affect me, right? So there are various symptoms and it varies. All right, so I wrote down something because I've been living with it for over 20 years, so I don't want to stray and share too much story without getting to the main points of this video. All right, so first thing, I wrote down 5 things I can't do because I live with sickle cell disease. 1, stay cold for too long. And this is very, very, very common among sickle cell patients or persons living with sickle cell disease. Sickle cell warriors, rather. We can't stay too cold for too long. What I normally do, thank God I'm living in a tropical country. What I normally do when I was living with my grandmother is that when I feel too cold in the day, it was in St. Anne, so you know it was cold. And when I'm feeling too cold, what I normally do is to go and sit in the sun, and it used to feel so good. Oh my God. It used to feel so good. I mean, I'm cold, but when I sit in the sun, I have the sun. You just have the warm feeling on your body from the sun, and it warms you up, you know. So that's how I normally cope if I'm feeling too cold. I used to do it a lot, maybe every day or every other day. My grandmother always used to wonder why I'm sitting in the sun. So grandma, if you're watching this video, or when you watch this video, that is the reason why I'm always sitting in the sun. All right, number 2, drink too much alcohol. I've never asked another sickler if I've never asked another warrior if alcohol affects them. I need to do that, but personally for me, I can't drink too much alcohol. But thankfully, I'm not somebody who craves alcohol. I'm not a habitual drinker, so it doesn't bother me at all that I can't have alcohol, much alcohol. It really doesn't bother me, but that's something I can't do because, you know, it sends me into crisis mode. All right, number 3, can't get too active. Now, this is something that bothers me. Because, listen, when I was in high school, at one point I wanted to be a part of the track team. But, unfortunately, each time I run, I realize that I feel pain, so I stopped. And then I was a part of the netball team. Not for long, I just went to a few training and then I stopped. But I think when I was a part of the basketball team, no, the females basketball team at Spot Valley High School, there was a tournament in town that we had to play. So it was like all the high schools coming together to play. I'm trying to remember if it was basketball or netball. I don't quite remember, but it's one of them. And my love, we were at the tournament and we're playing against schools. I remember Marcus Garvey Technical High School was there. That's the school that I passed for when I did GSAT. So I remember Marcus Garvey High School was there and I was like, you know, well ready and playing and, you know, having a good game. And master, by the time me reach Pandabus to go home, I was in so much pain. I was in so much pain from my head to my toe. That night, my mother didn't even get a night's rest because of the amount of pain I was feeling. So from that day, I decided I'm not going back on any basketball, netball, track, any team at all for my own, you know, for my own benefits, right? Because let me tell you something, sickle cell pain is no easy pain. Let me tell you something, sickle cell pain. Oof. All right, before I go off track, number four, I can't get too excited or if something frightens me. So if I get too excited, I go into a crisis. And if something or someone frightens me, I go into a crisis. Not all the time, but most times. So I have to try to always remain as calm as I possibly can in spite of any situation, whether it is good or bad. So I like to cheer. I like to, you know, I like the vibes and everything. As long as I don't get too excited, I'm fine. I'm good. I'm great. But once I get too excited, then you know what that is. Pain. Alright, number five, soak in water. So, on multiple occasions, I went to hotels, right? And I was unable to enjoy the day at the hotel because, for one, I can't soak in the water for too long, so it affects me. If I soak in the water for too long, I'm in pain. I can't, so a lot of things I can't do. So when I go to hotel, I normally just go into the water for maybe a 5 minutes, enjoy it, and I have to come back out and sit down again maybe for an next 2 minutes. I go in, enjoy it a bit, and I have to come back out again. All right so living with sickle cell, you just don't get to do what normal people do and enjoy. All right, so now we're moving on to five struggles I face with sickle cell disease. One is most times I feel weak. Most times I have a weak feeling, especially if I'm walking. I'll be fine. And I don't need to be walking for no period of time. I'm just walking. And then I just start to feel weak. I want to sit. I want to rest. I want to lie down. You know, most times I'm feeling weak. Two, struggle to put on weight. As a sickler, as a warrior, and I know other warriors as well, that we struggle to put on weight. You know, we're always, most of the times, we have a thin figure. We don't get too thick, right? So that's one of the struggles that we have. Number three, depression. Because to be honest, let me tell you something. You see, sickle cell, it is very, very, very stressing. Especially if you don't have the support to really stand behind you to say, listen, even though I can't feel what it is that you're going through, I am here for you. Right? So like living with the disease sometimes, to be honest, a lot of times when I was going to school, 90% of the persons at school don't know I have sickle cell. And I'm talking when I was attending college. 90% of the persons don't, of the pupils there, don't know I suffer from sickle cell disease. Not even my classmates. And a lot of times I'm in class and I'm in so much pain and I just rest my head on the desk. And I just try to pay attention. Whatever my lecturer is saying is just going through one ear and coming through the other because I'm in so much pain. But I have this thing where when I'm in too much pain, I try to tense so that I don't feel it. But you still feel it, but I don't know. It's just something that I try to do. One of the best things to do when I have sickle cell, when you're in a crisis, is to breathe. Breathe because it helps with the flow of oxygen, right? Which is good. But in my crisis, when I breathe or take deep breaths, I feel more pain. So I always try to tense up or get something to bite or hold on to or something like that. So that, you know? So a lot of times, sickle cell is very stressing. The people around you having to go to the hospital so many times, having been admitted, medication and all these things, you are frustrated a lot of times. Sometimes even though everybody is there around you to say, hey, we're here to support you, which is good, as I said before, but they really can't feel what you feel. And so sometimes it's so hard that sometimes some of us fall into depression. And we get frustrated, we're stressing over this sickness. Some persons I know have suicidal thoughts over this illness. Trust me, sickle cell is a lot. It's a whole works. It is. I wouldn't wish sickle cell disease on my worst enemy. When me tell us say, you're going to feel pain. The sort of pains that you're feeling, it's as if somebody's inside you, stabbing you. Like, I don't know how to explain the magnitude of the pain that you feel when you're living with sickle cell disease. It's as if somebody's, especially when you have pain in the head, it's as if somebody's tearing out your head from the inside, and you don't know. I'm telling you guys, like, it is so much. It is easy for warriors to fall into depression because it is a lot. It is so much. All right, moving on to number four, drug addict. To be honest, living with sickle cell disease will turn you into a drug addict because, as I said before, the pain is crucial, right? And it is fatal. It is a fatal disease. It can take your life, right? You know, so it's very serious, but it will turn you into a drug addict because the pain is so much. And sometimes the doctors will say, take one tablet 3 times daily to avoid pain. You're in pain only when you're in pain. So I get up this morning and I'm feeling pain. This is just an example. I get up this morning and I'm feeling some pain, so I'll take the one tablet half an hour later, the pain is getting worse instead of better. You take all 2-3 tablets, you know, because you're just trying. You will do anything just to get rid of the pain. Guys, I don't know how to explain to you how painful the pain is, how crucial it is, how tormenting it is. You can't sit down, you can't lie down, you don't know what to do with yourself, you don't know what to do with your body, you don't know what to do when you're in so much pain. I'm telling you, it is like the worst feeling in the world. So it will turn you into a drug addict. You just, especially if you're somebody like me, who I hate hospitals. I hate hospitals very much. And because of this, I will take my drugs because I don't want to go to the hospital. If I think I'm going to have a crisis, I take my medication, some pain meds. If I think I'm going to have a crisis, I take some pain meds because I don't want to have a crisis. And the thing is that, as I said before, it's easy to fall into depression. When you have sickle cell disease, your mind will play some mind games on you. So you'll start feeling as if, I feel like I'm going to have a crisis tonight. You know, I feel like I'm going to have pain. And so you're going to take one pill. And the thing is, you'll be sleeping and pain wakes you up. And by the time you should take the meds, at some serious pain you're in already. So because of that, if I just think I'm going to have a crisis, I take my meds. Right? So it will turn you into a drug addict. Not saying I'm a drug addict. Because I'm not, but the reality of it is I've taken drugs in the wrong proportion. I have overdosed myself more than once just to get rid of the pain. Trust me. All right, number five. That's where I'm at. Yes, pain. So yes. Struggle, the most stressing struggle, the most tormenting struggle of all is the pain that you feel when you're going to a crisis. I know sickle cell normally cripple people when they're in pain. As a matter of fact, when I was smaller, right, I went into a crisis and I could not walk or talk. I could not move, and my mother did not have any money to take me to the hospital. I vividly remember my mother taking me to a church and they prayed for me, and it was after the prayer that I was able to walk home. Sickle cell is very serious. All right, so finally, five misconceptions that persons have about sickle cell disease. One, it is not a communicable disease. Sickle cell disease is hereditary. So in layman terms, the father and the mother both have sickle cell anemia and have sex, produce a child, that child ends up with sickle cell disease. Most times, in most cases, the parents don't know that they have sickle cell anemia, because sickle cell anemia sometimes, not in all cases, but sometimes they don't affect the warriors, right? So they don't know that, listen, this is something I have, because they don't it doesn't affect them. That is why it is good to always get a checkup, right? Have some blood tests done to know these things. Two, pretending to be in pain. People normally think we're overdoing the pain that we're feeling. No, darling, if I could sometimes take something and mash it up and just to express how I'm feeling while I'm in pain, that is something that I would do. The pain is unbearable. Alright? Three, sickle cell, persons even with sickle cell can't get pregnant. That is not true. Persons, I know sickle cell warriors who have 3-4 children. You may have difficulty getting pregnant because, you know, for various reasons. And one of the main things is that when you are pregnant as a sickle cell warrior, especially if you're not getting checkup regularly from the doctors, the thing that will happen is that you're normally going to crisis very often, and it leads to them taking the baby earlier than the baby should born, right? Another thing, number four, is that a sickle will never live beyond 30 years old. That is not true. I've known, I don't know them, but I normally see them on the internet. Persons living with sickle cell, and they are 70. As a matter of fact, I do know a lady who is living here in St. James. She has sickle cell disease. She has three children, and she's now 40 something years old. All right, so we do live beyond 30 years old. And then final number five finally is all sicklers feel pain. That is not true, because they have sickle cell disease, as I said before, and sickle cell anemia. And persons with sickle cell anemia, not all the time they feel, not in all cases they feel pain. They don't always feel pain. All right, so these are the 5 misconceptions that I want to clear up. Thank you so much for watching my video. Please remember to subscribe, share, comment, ask me any question about sickle cell. I will answer. Share your views on sickle cell, your thoughts. I made a commitment that I would live from I was 12 years old. Doctor said I will not live to see 12, and if I do live to see 12 years old, I will not live beyond 12 years old. And today I'm 23 years old, right? So I made a commitment that I will live my best life with sickle cell disease, right? So I just want to encourage somebody out there that you can do it. We are warriors on this earth, all right? But living life, being the best me, here comes another disease in 2019 that I was diagnosed with. But that I'll tell you in my next video, all right? So just keep safe and remember to share with a sickle cell warrior. Let them know that there's hope out there for them and that it is not the end of the world. We can live, we won't even survive, we will live. Not survive, but we'll live with sickle cell disease. We are warriors, all right? And assist somebody with sickle cell, help them. Give them a word of encouragement. It doesn't have to be financial help. Just encourage somebody, tell them a joke, let them laugh, do something.